Welcome back to OneStopTutorials.com. Alibaba here once again from sunny Thailand. This is it. We've started our mission. We're now on to Macromedia Dreamweaver. We're going to be building our own websites. No more paying all those top dollar money to have a website built. You're going to start doing it yourself. So when you open up Dreamweaver for the very first time, okay, the Dreamweaver icon looks like this, or it will look like the Photoshop one, and it will have a big D on it, DS, depending on which version you're using. So when you double click onto that, this page will come up here. Before this page, you might get if you open it up for the very first time, you might get two boxes that ask if you want a design view or code view. Depending on which one you want to use, more than likely to start with, it's easier to use design view and then go into the code view than just having the code view set up all the time, okay? So choose the design view, and then this page will come up, which will give us some options. Now, if you've opened it up for the first time, more than likely there'll be nothing in this line here, but this is all the files that we have recently opened up inside of Dreamweaver, okay? Next one along is create a new file, so you have all your different file types, HTML, PHP, XML, whatever you want to do, CSS, okay? There's some more ones down here that are done already. And then you got create from samples, so Dreamweaver makes samples of CSS and starter pages and stuff where you can choose them and then put them into Dreamweaver and modify them. Okay, so this is the general outlay. Now what we're going to do in this tutorial, we're just going to make a simple HTML. So we're going to hover the mouse over, left click, and we're going to choose HTML just so we can get in and have a look at this interface. Now when you come into it, you'll notice that there's a big white screen, nothing there, nothing fancy. And at the top here, you'll have yourself a bar that is called Insert. Okay. Now Insert has different options. You can go to Common, Layout, Forms, Text. Okay. Common is just, as it says, the common stuff that people might use. You've got hyperlinks, email links, anchor points, this is tables. You can add images, you can mess around with flash media, okay, date, time. More than likely we'll be using these ones here, especially the table, and we'll be using the image one a couple of times, but we won't be focusing on the image one because there's so many ways to bring into images into Dreamweaver that I don't really use this button that much. I use more user-friendly interactive ways, okay. Next one along is layout. We will definitely be using this tab. This is for building tables. Tables are very, very important inside of Dreamweaver. Okay. Next one is forms. This is for our contact form where we'll come in and we'll choose different stuff, you know, check boxes, radio buttons. So again, we'll come in. And these other ones here, text, HTML, application, flash elements, favorites, you probably will not be using that much in this particular course. You can, if you inside of this gray box here, in any one of them, okay, inside, you can right click and you can choose customize favorites, which means you can choose the ones that you use the most. Let's say you use a navigation bar, you can left click on that, choose the arrows, that will go into the favorite objects, and when you hit okay, you'll notice inside of the favorites, you've just added your navigation bar. Okay, so that's if you want to set up your own ones and use yours. I'm just going to use the common ones. Moving down, we've got here, this is the design view. So this is the view that anywhere that you type, okay, or do anything, you can see it. This is the split view, which will allow you to go between the code and this design view. Okay, so you can see both. And this is the code view that will do your HTML code for you. And it always starts you off with your doc type, your head, and your body tags. Okay, and the good thing about Dreamweaver is that if you add spaces and you type and stuff and do whatever you want, when you come into the code view, it automatically puts the HTML coding in for you. That's why Dreamweaver is so good for new people, because you don't have to get into the nitty gritty. You can build it as a design view and then come into the code later on if you wish. Moving along, this one is a title tag that I showed you. This is very, very important. We will go over this. This is what helps you get ranked in Google and gives a good title to the page. These are tabs to validate your actual documents and make sure that your HTML code is clean. You then have your preview. Preview allows you to view it in different browsers. I have Firefox and Internet Explorer, but you could go to with left clicking on that globe, you could go to edit browsers, and you can choose from here how to add a new browser. You just hit browse and you choose where the new browser is. Okay, so if you're running Safari or Opera or something like that, you can add them as well. And then the next we have here is visual aids, which we'll be using, which gives us these little aid drop down things that allow us to help us along. Okay, then you got minimize, usual, make page smaller, this one, and then you got delete. Okay, moving down to the panel on the right here, this panel here we will come into a lot of the time. This has your files. This is where we're going to make a site. We're going to do that in the next tutorial. Okay, well, that's why we'll go over more on that. But in here you have your assets, which shows you your images that you're using, your swatches, the colors inside of your website. It'll allow you to do a library element, which we'll definitely show you later on. Okay, so that's the files. You just click on them, left click, close them. Next is the tag inspector, which will do us a behavior. We're going to be doing that with the rollover image in the gallery section. We'll be adding a swap image. Okay, it'll be here, swap image. So this is adding behaviors. And then you've got your applications, which we're not actually going to go into, but they're the database binding applications. And then we got the CSS, which we will be going into. We'll be making a CSS, and I will talk more about that later. All these menus can be dragged down, okay, dragged down. They can be dragged off, okay. You can do all stuff like that, exactly just like in Photoshop, where it's like that, user-friendly. I like to have file at the top, the bottom. Okay, moving on down, you can open these side menus just by hitting these little arrows. So you can open, close, okay. Same as the bottom one, we've got one at the bottom here. And when you click on the bottom one, this brings you into the properties, which will add us H1, H2, H3 in our paragraph tags and the rest of the stuff. This is your style for your CSS. We'll get into this when we get into CSS. You call upon your style in certain areas. And the rest of the stuff here is very similar to any other Word programs or anything like that. Bold, italic, left, center, right, and justify. This will allow you to do unordered lists. This is your ordered lists. This is your page properties, which we'll go into a little bit, which will allow you to change the background color, text color, add a background image, whether you want to repeat it and how many times. And then you can add your margins. Then you can come into your links, add your links, and then you can add a hover effect over your links. Okay, this is for your links. This is where you can find your links and set them up. So that's this tab. Then you have here, you can change it from 100% to 6%, which makes the page smaller, to 1600%. So it's a zoom tool. Okay, this is the hand tool. When you're in the zoom tool, you can move around. And then this is just the normal select tool. Along the outside of our page here, we have a ruler, and you can change it from inches to centimeters. Okay, reset ruler or hide ruler. Okay, so that's the general interface of Macromedia inside here. We'll go into more as we're doing our projects. I just wanted to give you a quick outline. I wanted to prove to you that this program is not as scary as it may seem. I might have spoken really fast here, but I have a tendency of doing that. If you find I have, just simply stop, rewind, and listen again. But like I say, it isn't really, really important, because when we're doing the project, we're going to be coming into this more. Okay, guys and girls, we're on our way. We're gonna be booming along now, as I say, booming. The next one will be on how to add a new site, so you can get your folder structure ready, get ready, and then we'll be able to get moving and start using tables to start building our website. Are you feeling scared? Can you feel the power of a website in front of you? Take it easy, guys and girls. I'll catch you at the next one-stop tutorials. And I shall see you there. Laters.